When working with photodetectors in an optics experiment, it's important to understand the basic operating principles of the detector. Let's start by looking at the principles of photodiodes, and then we'll look at the electronics that surround those to make up a detector. A photodiode is a junction between a positively and negatively doped semiconductor, often with an intrinsic or undoped region in between. If positive charge carriers are introduced in the positive doped region of the device, they can flow across the junction and combine with negative charge carriers at the junction. But when the applied voltage is reversed, the charge carriers are pulled away from the junction, leaving a depleted region that prevents current flow. In this way, the device allows current to flow in only one direction. It's a diode. When a photon with an energy above the band gap of the semiconductor is incident on the junction, it is absorbed and produces a pair of charge carriers, an electron and a hole. Normally, these charge carriers would quickly attract each other and recombine. But in the presence of a strong electric field, they can be accelerated away from each other, inducing a current through the junction. This electric field is provided by a voltage across the electrodes on either side of the junction. This voltage produces a reverse bias in the diode, so that in the absence of photoabsorption, there's no current flowing through the diode. But when illuminated by light with sufficiently energetic photons, a current will be induced that's proportional to the incident power. Since the photodiode produces a current that's proportional to the incident power, if we connect it to an oscilloscope or other instrument and measure the voltage, we'll get a value that depends on the incident power and the impedance that the photodiode is connected to. Usually that's the input impedance of the instrument. An oscilloscope with a 1 megaohm input impedance will display a signal that's 20,000 times larger